Hey guys, my name's Sam and welcome to Prep Medic. This week's video, we are talking about RECON Medical, specifically the RECON Tourniquet, and why I'm happy it's no longer being manufactured. So in the last 3 weeks, Composite Resources, who is the parent company to North American Rescue, who manufactures the combat application tourniquet, won in a lawsuit against RECON Medical for patent infringement. RECON Medical manufactures the RECON Tourniquet, which is a cat lookalike. They've made a couple notable changes. Number one, they made the windlass. They took it from this composite material and they made it aluminum. And then they put a thumb hole in the strap here to supposedly make it easier to tighten on patients' arms. The other notable thing about this tourniquet, and the reason why a lot of you have probably bought this tourniquet, is because it's about half the cost of the cat. So you can get basically the same tourniquet for half the cost. So you might be thinking, Sam, that sounds like a great deal. A tourniquet that's basically the same as the cat tourniquet. Why wouldn't you recommend that? And that's really what I want to dive into today because I have never been a fan of them. So number one, the RECON Medical tourniquet fixed issues with the cat that really weren't issues. New generations of the cat tourniquet, the Gen 6, the Gen 7, which is the most recent one, do not have any data to support that this windlass is flimsy or will break. The only times that you have windlass failures with genuine cat tourniquets is if the initial tightening was not very tight and you start turning this band over and over and over again to make up that slack. In those cases, you can get a windlass failure. However, more often than not, you're gonna have an internal band failure. In my opinion, it's no better there. Number two, the thumb hole, I don't really see a point for it. I don't really know of anybody that's had trouble pulling this band tight without that. If that's something you really like, okay, go figure. But I think it kind of fixed two issues that don't exist. But my main issue with them is that they were manufactured in China, which for, you know, certain pieces of nylon that aren't medical equipment, okay, sure, if you want to have something that's manufactured in China, it's probably okay, go for it. But for a medical device, this China manufacturer had no quality control. So RECON Medical had no way of doing quality control on their products. And during the lawsuit with Composite Resources, the CEO of RECON Medical actually admitted that they've had issues with delamination, with the Velcro and some other components with the RECON tourniquet. So I've heard some anecdotal reports of the RECON Medical tourniquet failing. Now, anecdotal evidence, like right on the surface, really isn't worth much. However, if you actually look for data on the RECON Medical tourniquet, there's really nothing out there. RECON Medical published their own paper on their newest version. However, that's kind of research 101. It's funded by the company that manufactures the product, so it is not going to be the most objective research out there. Beyond that, I can't find any independent research that says it's a good tourniquet. There's no data. Couple that with the anecdotal reports of failure, that has me worried. Now, it would be one thing if RECON Medical created the only tourniquet of its kind and, you know, that's all there was, because it will probably work most of the time. That probably and most of the time should be kind of a scary word for you, considering that we have tourniquets like the cat tourniquet that actually have a lot of data behind them. We know what their failure points are, we know what they're able to withstand, and they're evidence-based. Especially now that the Committee for Tactical Combat Casualty Care has released an increased list of tourniquets that are recommended by them, I don't really see a reason to go with the RECON Medical. On its surface, it might look more sturdy, it might feel good, and you might like that extra 20 bucks in your pockets, but my personal recommendation would be to save a little bit extra money and buy something that is actually evidence-based. I'm sure there's going to be some disagreements down below. Leave them down there. I would love to see the discussion, and I will see you next week.